The woman wearing red, representing Sweden, ahead of her second bout here at the Olympic Games in London 2012, is one of the most decorated women amateur boxers of all time. A two-time world champion at 75 kilograms in a middleweight division in 2001, the first ever world championships in Scranton 11 years ago, and also in 2005. And her opponent is at the opposite end of the experience spectrum. It is a teenage phenom from Flint, Michigan, 17 years of age, Claressa Shields from the United States of America, approaching the ring for her Olympic debut.
Well, we've heard a huge amount, Ron, about Claressa Shields in the lead up to this Olympics. She's a little superstar in the USA, only 17 years old, as you say. She went into the World Championships earlier on this year, undefeated, but succumbed to Great Britain's Savannah Marshall in the second preliminary round.
The opening bell sounds in this women's 75 kilogram middleweight bout between the boxer wearing red, representing Sweden. The tallest boxer in the competition at 6 feet tall is Anna Laurel, a former two-time world championship gold medalist at 75 kilograms, and her opponent is somebody just beginning her international senior career, 17-year-old teenage phenom from Flint, Michigan in the United States of America, Claressa Shields. Possesses terrific hand speed, does Shields. That is one of the hallmarks of her boxing. And she's just beginning her international senior career, entered the World Championships after taking gold at the Pan American Women's Championship. She was undefeated in international competition. Most of that did take place in North America. As she traveled for the first time, she came up short against Great Britain Savannah Marshall to experience her first loss in the USA vest. But now here she is, competing on the Olympic stage. And the shorter boxer is on the front foot and the aggressor in this opening round.
Claressa Shields, just content, just to command the center there, getting a feel for what Laurel has got. And Laurel, in contrast, just trying to keep it at range. I'd pick her off with the jab and the check hook as Shields comes in.
So inside the final 30 seconds, it's a speculative foray to the body by Shields. Good left hook to finish that little exchange, and then once more a long looping left catches Laurel, who had similar problems in her opening bout with the speed of her opponent. That was against the Australian Fisher Rasmussen yesterday. She made terrific adjustments in subsequent rounds, and one suspects she's going to have to find similar adjustments here as she's content to operate on the perimeter of the ring and just snapped home a good left jab before that closing bell. But despite her aggression, Claressa Shields finds herself trailing by two. Let's listen in.
Well, we see Laurel there landing with a strong jab, followed by a rear hand, cuffing rear hand. And again there with a 1-2 combination leading with a rear hand. I think Laurel scored her points in the early part of the round, and as Shields got into the flow, got into the momentum, we began to see what she's capable of.
He Into the second round we go. It's scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds in the women's 75-kilogram middleweight division between the boxer wearing red, representing Sweden, 32 years of age, one of the most decorated and respected female amateur boxers of all time, Anna Laurel, two-time world championship gold medalist. Back at the inaugural championships, she just received a stiff left hand from Claressa Shields there. Three-time gold medalist in European championships as well, against an opponent just beginning her international career, but who possesses immense talent. Claressa Shields from the USA, just 17 years of age, and is the 2012 Pan American Women's Champion, having defeated Mary Spencer, Canada's legendary boxer, in the final.
Well, we heard the American coach there telling Shields to use the jab. I'm not sure that's been hugely effective against a taller, rangier boxer, unless she doubles up the jab and follows it with a rear hand. I think what she's doing and what's coming off very effective is she throws to the body first, she gets inside that range, and then she can throw the shots to the head. This is what she needs to do more of. She needs to go to the body, then to the head.
Laurel remaining very composed in the face of the aggression being demonstrated by Shields. Shields got through with a good shot to the body. Again, rather untidy on the inside, and for the second time in the round, Laurel warned, who she scored with a good long right cross. Beautiful corkscrew uppercut underneath by Laurel, but then she takes a stiff shot in reply from Shields.
Short, sharp right hand there to end that sequence by Shields.
And now it's Laurel commanding center ring. Shields content to use her lateral movement on the outside in an effort to draw Laurel in. So real cat and mouse strategy being employed now, as a hard right hand is dug into the body by Shields. And look at her work away with that right hand to Laurel's ribcage. Being warned for holding and hitting. Remember, the referee will only issue three commands in amateur boxing: stop, box, and break, as Shields got through with a good right hand. Laurel rather untidy at close quarters. And as the bell sounds to end at round at number two, Shields has closed the deficit. It stood at 2 points, she's reduced it to one, but she still trailed by 7 points to 6 to Anna Laurel from Sweden after two completed rounds of boxing.
We see on the replay here, Laurel landing a jab, but that's followed up with Shields on a long looping rear hook. I tell you what, Ron, these punches from Shields are not light. They're not tippy-tappy punches. I think you know when you've been hit by this girl. Look at this hook, knocking Laurel off balance there.
Into the second half of this women's 75 kilogram middleweight contest we go, between Anna Laurel, the former two-time world championship gold medalist, three-time European champion as well. She's wearing red, representing Sweden, being picked off by some hard singles now. And just listen to those shots thudding into the ribcage of Laurel from Claressa Shields, 17 years of age, from Flint, Michigan in the United States. What a right hand from Shields once more, whose hand speed is absolutely blazing here in the third round. Good shot to the body by Shields, followed up with a left hook upstairs. And when Laurel began boxing in 1997, Claressa Shields was just 2 years old. She started boxing when she was 11, because she's landing more effective shots before the boxers fall into a clinch. And she started boxing because of her dad. She was 9 years old when Claressa kind of absorbed his passion for boxing. Good shot. But then Shields is warned about keeping, about the shot straying low. And so has absorbed her father's passion for boxing and competing here on the Olympic stage.
Yeah, Shields is getting the success here when she switches from the body to the head. And that left hook, devastating left hook, ending on that left hook, is knocking Laurel off her balance.
So Laurel on the front foot now before going back to center ring and waiting for a response from Shields. Plenty of twitching and feinting taking place, just looking for one of those crucial openings. Good right uppercut from Laurel. And it's back at range once more. Terrific straight shots fired in by Laurel at range. And Laurel remaining incredibly composed in the face of this aggression and hard punching aggression from Shields, and just picks her off with a jab once more. So as the closing bell sounds to bring about an end to round number two, the round favors Shields with that marauding aggression. She has again reduced the deficit. It is 12 points apiece after three completed rounds of boxing.
Well, I think that score reflects the bout. There we go, we hear the corner there saying you've got to double up the jab and throw the right hand. I agree. She also needs to throw the combinations head and body. She continues in that vein to throw those combinations as she did in that last round. We may well see Shields crown the victor.
As we move into the fourth and final round in the women's 75 kilogram weight class, this contest has been incredibly competitive between boxers at opposite ends of the experience spectrum. Anna Laurel representing Sweden wearing red, and her opponent is Claressa Shields, who scores with a hard right hand left hook combination. And it's been accurate punching like that that has seen her prevail in rounds two and three after losing the opening round by a score of 4-2. It is tied at 12 points apiece. So everything to box for between these two contestants. And it's the woman wearing red who was competing regardless of the outcome in her first and final Olympic Games. Anna Laurel is 32 years old and takes a thunderous left hook. Shields is hyped up and it brings about a standing count here in the fourth and final round.
What an astonishing hook that was. I'm not sure Laurel has collected her head entirely, although she's stalking her opponent now on the front foot, suggesting that she did well to ride that punch.
Right hand to the body driven in, and then at close quarters, it's Shields working away with the right hand. And having been tied at 12 points apiece, one suspects that the momentum is just with Shields as we enter the final 30 seconds of this fourth and final round. And Laurel, she will know that she's been tagged by a couple of clean punches and will be looking to land effectively by using that superior reach that she possesses. The tallest boxer in the tournament had been closed down effectively during the course of rounds two, three, and indeed four. And as we approach the final 15 seconds, Shields is the aggressor once more, landing effectively, and she could well have done enough. Remember, she brought about a standing count here in the fourth round. Laurel trying to work away at close quarters. But as the closing bell sounds, Claressa Shields is in absolutely no doubt that she has overturned the legendary figure in women's boxing, who is Anna Laurel, the two-time World Championship gold medalist, the three-time European champion. She took round one, did Laurel, but slowly, almost imperceptibly, Shields fought her way back with hard, accurate punching like that, and it was that left hook that brought about the only standing count of the contest.
Yeah, what a thrilling conclusion to that contest, Ron. And my goodness, you can see in that replay the power in that left hook of Claressa Shields. She raises her hands. She believes she did enough to do it, did enough to claim the win.
Both boxers raising their hands in anticipation of victory. That moment will be confirmed when the official verdict is announced to this capacity-filled crowd here at London's XL Arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by score 18 points to 40 in the blue corner, representing the United States of America, Claressa Shields.
Claressa Shields from Flint, Michigan, jumps for joy after being announced as the winner in the women's 75 kilogram weight class quarterfinal. She's guaranteed herself a place on the podium at the very start of her international career. It's a masterful performance. You see the way she eased her way back into the contest. After trailing by 2 points at the end of the first round, she won every single subsequent round, and to the victor the spoils. She'll have an Olympic medal guaranteed now that she has progressed through to the quarterfinals. Job, good job, well done, overcoming the immense ability and experience of Anna Larell of Sweden.
Well, another upset there, Ron. We heard so much hype about this young